find the greatest common factor of these monomials. And when they say monomials, that's just a fancy word for saying a one-term expression. Each of these only obviously have one term in them. Now, to find the greatest common factor of these, the way I think about it is I like to break up each of these terms into their constituent parts, make them a product of the simplest things possible. For regular numbers like 10, to me, that means break them up into their prime factors. And for these variable expressions, like c, d squared, break it up into the product of the most simple a variable. For example, c times d times d. So let's do that for each of them and see what the greatest common factor is. Where do these overlap in terms of their factor? And we care about the greatest overlap. So let's do this first one. 10 cd squared, what is that equal to? Well, 10 is equal to 2 times 5 is equal to 2 times 5. You could do a factoring tree here, but these are pretty straightforward numbers to factor into their prime factors. So 10 is 2 times 5. C, all you can do is break that. You can just write that as a C. No, you can't really simplify that anymore. And d squared can be written as d times d. Times d times d. So I've essentially broken 10 cd squared into the product of kind of the smallest constituents that I could think of. The prime factors of 10, and then c, and then d. Now let's do 5 cd. Well, 5 cd, 5 is prime, so its prime factorization is literally just 5. C, you can't break that down anymore. That's just a c, and then times a d. So this, we really didn't do anything to this expression right there. And then finally, you have 25 c to the third d squared. Well, 25 is 5 times 5. And then we have times c times c times c. That's what c to the third is. And then we have times d squared, times d times d. Now, what is the greatest common factor, or what is the greatest common overlap between these three things? Well, they all have a 5. Let me circle them. You have a 5 there. You have a 5 there. You have a 5 there. They all have at least one c. You have one c there, one c there, and then another c there. And they all have at least one d. You have a d there, you have a d there, and then you have a d there. Now, they don't all have a second d. Only the first one and the third one have a second d. And they all don't have a second or third c. Only this last one has a second or third c. So we're essentially done. The greatest common factor is 5 cd. In fact, you can't have a greater number than 5 cd be a common factor, because the largest factor of 5 cd is 5 cd. So the greatest common factor of these three monomials, or these three expressions, is 5 cd. The largest number of factors that overlaps with all three of these expressions is a 5, 1 c, and 1 d.